I'm Jill Zamek with Mothers for Peace. I live in Rio Grande. I would like to first preface my comments with the acknowledgement that the NRC is looking for new information here today, issues to look at specifically for Diablo Canyon, and there are numerous such issues. But the two most pressing, which are not new, are one, this plant has been absurdly sited in an area riddled with active earthquake faults, and two, we still don't know how to protect the byproduct known as high-level radioactive waste, which remains toxic for hundreds of thousands of years. You might label these generic issues, but they are the primary concerns of the residents in this community. An additional issue is that Pacific Gas and Electric Company has lost its credibility. The Japanese parliament concluded that collusion between regulator, industry, and government officials was the root cause of the ongoing Fukushima nuclear catastrophe. Trying to namely, the Diablo Canyon plant is operated by PG&E, a company under multiple federal indictments for safety violations in a recent fatal explosion of its San Bruno, California gas pipeline. It is also embroiled in an evolving scandal about illegal back-channel communications with the state's Public Utilities Commission. We cannot trust this company to maintain public safety as their highest priority. We do not want a Fukushima in California. This is a site-specific issue relating only to the owner of the Diablo Canyon nuclear facility. A further topic is the threat of tsunami. I understand that PG&E and the NRC feel protected from the tsunami threat because of the 85-foot cliff and the placement of the snorkels, but that secure feeling is not shared by all. In a report which the NRC held private for 11 years, a preliminary numerical study of the hazard for local landslide tsunami scenarios the Diablo Canyon site in Central California, published November 22, 2003, the investigator Dr. R.T. Sewell concluded that, quote, the existing tsunami design bases and perceptions of tsunami risk for the Diablo Canyon site no longer reflect modern scientific understanding and methods. There is compelling evidence to suggest that the tsunami threat may be considerably more significant than held in these existing bases and perceptions, and correspondingly, such existing bases and perceptions no longer appear adequate, end quote. Dr. Stiegel provided six recommendations in his concluding comments of his report, one of them being that the licensee of the Diablo Canyon site, quote, justify and/or reevaluate the tsunami design bases and perform a state-of-the-art assessment of tsunami hazard and risk, including the plant and its within the umbrella of its existing long-term seismic program, end quote. When combining the effects of tsunami tides, storm surge, and winds, all of Sewell's 13 postulated scenarios of the investigation produced waves that go beyond Diablo Canyon's design basis. In fact, all 13 scenarios produced wave heights that could impact the seawater intake. This issue is certainly site-specific environmental concern allows Fukushima to be our warning.